Hey guys, Kieran here and you're very welcome to the channel. I just watched a video of Elon Musk speaking at the World AI Conference in Shanghai about just how close Tesla are to achieving full self-driving. And as a shareholder, this got me super excited. Here's the clip.
I'm extremely confident that level 5 or essentially complete autonomy will be will happen. And I think it will happen very quickly. I think at Tesla, I feel like we're very close to level 5 autonomy. I remain confident that we will have the functionality for the basic functionality for level 5 autonomy complete this year.
I've been following the advances in this space for some time, and we're blessed because while there's at least a dozen companies working hard trying to solve the problem of self-driving, there's at least 4 million YouTubers working just as hard to solve the even bigger problem of who's going to reach level 5 full autonomy first. So there is a great amount of information available on YouTube about this subject. Now I'll say, while I am a self-confessed Tesla fanboy, I'm an investor first and foremost, and I want to invest in the winner in the race to fully self-driving, because I think whoever wins this is going to change the world and ultimately have a gigantic market cap. So I've always tried to be as non-biased as I can when it comes to researching this stuff. And in case you're new to this subject, by the way, there's essentially 5 different levels of autonomy. The levels range from level 0 all the way up to level 5. Level 0 basically means zero autonomy, and the human driver is in full control of the car at all times. The level of autonomy then increases with each level all the way up to level 5, where the car can drive anywhere by itself without the need of a human occupant. Now, when you look at all the different players in the game, you essentially realize that there's 2 different strategies at play here for trying to solve this complex problem. You have Tesla, AI, and Mobileye, and a couple of others that are essentially using cameras and deep learning. And they are currently at level 2 and trying to slowly, incrementally get to level 5. The idea behind this strategy stems from the fact that our driving infrastructure is built for vision, and that as humans, we can drive pretty well with just 2 eyes to perceive the world and a brain to make decisions. These companies thus use cameras to see the world, and they're developing complex machine learning systems to be able to perceive and react to what they see. They are currently at level 2 autonomy, and they're slowly trying to incrementally increase the way up to level 5 as their machine learning algorithms improve over time. On the other side of the fence then, you have other players such as Waymo, Cruise, and Uber, who are essentially using cameras with LiDAR, which is essentially laser shooting sensors. They are trying to go straight to level 4, whereby they are fully autonomous but within the confines of a geo-fenced area. Once they get there then, they want to scale out geographically. Now there are a couple of distinguishing factors between these 2 groups. The first one, and the obvious one, is do we need LiDAR, yes or no? The second one then is, which is a better strategy? Incrementally going from level 2 to level 5, or going straight to level 4 and then scaling geographically? The third factor that distinguishes these groups is data collection. Now we could argue all day over 1 and 2. Tesla's and other companies using just vision are adamant that LiDAR is not required, and that scaling from level 2 to level 5 is the only true way to ever really reach level 5 autonomy. Waymo and other companies taking the LiDAR approach argue the opposite. They feel that LiDAR is required if we're to ever truly reach full self-driving safely. One thing we cannot argue over though is the data collection mechanisms and the level of data these companies have. Because in my mind, Tesla has a crazy advantage in this area. They have over 800,000 cars driving around collecting data. And in total, they have about 3 billion miles of data collected. To put this in context, Waymo only has about 30 million miles collected. Nobody else other than a car company with the integrated self-driving hardware could possibly take this approach. And Tesla are the only car company with the required hardware and the software. Even Google could not afford to do this. I mean, could you imagine if you actually had to pay for this level of data to be collected? It would cost you tens of billions, and it would take you years and years to complete. And trust me on this, because I've done the calculations. And to put some context on this, right? We know that GM bought Cruise Automation in 2016 for $500 million. And we know from a lawsuit where Waymo sued Uber for stealing trade secrets that Waymo spent roughly $1.1 billion on their projects from 2009 to 2015. We also know that Zoox raised roughly $1 billion to fund their project and is now being bought by Amazon for roughly $1.1 billion. So clearly nobody's in a position to spend $10 billion plus on data collection. Now, Waymo countered this argument by saying that they're running simulation miles. And while I'm sure this does provide value, I just can't imagine that it's going to account for all the edge cases, all the really, really weird situations that happen in real life that are just unpredictable and cannot be predicted by a simulation. Yet humans are able to perceive these things and react to them in a safe manner. I think that this race to self-driving is like a game of chess that's been played out over the last decade. Each player is making their moves, hoping to get a checkmate first. I believe though that this game was won very early on when Tesla made the strategic decision to equip all their cars with full self-driving hardware and over-the-air updates. In this move, Tesla kicked off a strategy that was much more effective than all the other companies. And because they're actually a car company, they could actually do this. They have an insurmountable advantage over all these other companies that are just standalone self-driving companies. I honestly don't believe that these other companies realized the strategic advantage that Tesla had early on, and they just went about executing their original strategy. By the time they realized that their original strategy wasn't going to win, it was already too late. Too many moves had been made, too much time had been lost, too much money had been raised, and too much money had been spent. The winning player had made too much ground to ever be caught. Most executives in the auto industry are still betting against Tesla. They don't think Tesla can do what they say they can. They all see autonomy arriving slowly in geo-fenced areas using ugly and expensive equipment not found on consumer cars. If they're right, then Waymo's R&D makes good sense and all the miles that Tesla has driven won't matter because they won't have been driven using the right equipment. And we will have to wait until 2030 to see autonomy in consumer cars. But if, as I suspect, Tesla can deliver autonomy in the next couple of years reasonably and so inexpensively that it's actually available in consumer cars, then holy shit, this is game over. And not just for Waymo, but also for Nikola and snake oil salesman Trevor Milton. I mean, when Tesla's Semi is fully autonomous and Nikola's isn't, how did they even have a chance? And guys, this is just one of the reasons, one of the many reasons that Tesla is the most valuable auto company in the world. Because while Wall Street hasn't copped onto it yet, us consumer investors see the potential for this company to absolutely change the world. Guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, then please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't yet, then consider subscribing to the channel. Also, let me know in the comments below if you think Tesla is going to win the race to full self-driving. And if not, let me know why. I'm very curious to hear your thoughts. Okay, so that's it. Thanks very much for watching. Have a lovely day, and I'll see you in the next video.